Welcome to the Fall Choir Preview, featuring the Shelsford High School Treble Chamber and Choir Concert Choirs under the direction of Michaela Martin and accompanied by Lori Grayson. Our students have worked very hard to prepare for this concert, and we hope you enjoy their efforts. To that end, we would appreciate your cooperation and demonstration of great concert etiquette as outlined in your program. Specifically, we would like to ask you for your attention to the following details. Please turn off or silence all mobile and digital devices. Please remain seated for the entire concert to show appreciation for the work of all performers and performing groups. And if you must exit the auditorium, we do ask that you do so between songs. The students of the Shelsford High School Choir Department will also be modeling exceptional audience behavior tonight, so we thank you for your support of their efforts. Now, please rise and join the choirs as we begin tonight's performance with the Star Spangled Banner.
Good evening and welcome. Thank you so much for being here. The first concert of the season is always one of my favorites. And not because they're doing the best music they're going to do all year or because they're at where we want them to be by this point, but it is because it sets us up for a great year. And that's, I think, what you're going to see tonight. I'm excited about where these classes are right now. This is mostly a kind of a works in progress, so you can see what we've been up to so far, and so you can see what we have to look forward to throughout the rest of the year. So I'm very excited to be here tonight, and I'm glad to have you all joining us. I wanted to just talk to you a little bit about most of the songs we're going to sing, just to kind of bring you into the fold a little bit. The treble on stage in front of you has been working hard on finding our choral sound. The couple pieces we'll be performing for you are greatly contrasting compositions, but they're both on the theme of happiness, and that is definitely something we can all use a bit more of in our daily lives. The first song is in the Navajo language, and it includes drums, shakers, and body percussion. The second piece is a more modern arrangement, but it is inspired by the works of Johann Sebastian Bach. So I hope you enjoy. This is the Treble Choir.
Oh.
while they're bringing up the piano, I'm going to fill the silence by telling you a little bit about this piano. This is the same old grand piano we've had, or at least it kind of is. It was actually rebuilt for us over the summer, thanks to the school district for spending a very large chunk of money from the Pebble Fund. Thank you to the community for voting in the Pebble Fund again. But we had this thing rebuilt. The entire inside pretty much is brand new, and when it was delivered, and the outer shell is this beautiful satin finish. What's really cool is that when it came back to us and they unloaded it and I sat down and played it a little bit, it really felt like a brand new piano. It is very much a privilege to be a part of a district that cares enough really to support the arts and especially in that way that takes a lot of money. So thank you to everyone involved with that, and we will get on. Before the school year started, these folks in front of you were attending camps and getting into the nitty-gritty of the all-state process. They have worked really, really hard to learn very complex music and polish it within their ensembles. What you're about to hear is a short version of what might be heard at their auditions this coming Saturday. It's a very long day, and it's a very exciting and nerve-wracking and all those things process, and we're very, very proud of them. They will be auditioning on just little selections of the five pieces they've learned. They are performing completely a cappella and within duets and one trio. So it is difficult and intimidating process, and I'm really proud of how far these kids have come. So we will get on with our All-State audition. Audition? sung in groups before can attest, what they just did is really hard. Where some of them were singing, they're the only person on their part, and so I think we can all have a healthy amount of respect for what they just did, and they did it on stage. So how about another round of applause for these guys? So the chamber choir is our only audition group here at the high school. Students go through auditions in the spring and recalls, where we find our group sound and put together this ensemble. When the school year begins, so do the 6:45 a.m. rehearsals. That is difficult for all of us. Yes, all of us. But they do a great job, and a lot of the time we're actually having fun somehow at 6:45 in the morning. It's a lot to ask of these kids, and but they do it, and I'm very thankful. This group also prepares for Veterans Day, Womack Choral Festival, and they've actually already begun looking at their caroling music, because they're also our community outreach group, and perform a lot of Christmas carols around the community. It's a really busy start to the school year, and they've been really impressive in their work so far. The first piece is only a portion of the entire piece. It is just an excerpt of Lullaby, but it is beautiful, and we wanted to share some of what we've accomplished so far, and just kind of share that work in progress with you. The second piece will actually feature many of our talented members as soloists, and their names have been outlined in the program for you. As we transition again, I want to take a moment to recognize a few more of our awesome students. Directly after the end of last school year, several of our incoming freshmen began working toward Opus auditions. We practiced the music for a couple weeks right away in June, then brought it back out after another couple weeks, or for another couple weeks just before school started this fall. The reward of that hard work is sweet for three of our students who found out last week that they were accepted, and another who was chosen as an alternate. Please join me in congratulating Ellery Johnson and Maddie Beecham, Darby Flynn, who is one of the solo finalists, and Bryce Walker, who was chosen as an alternate. Those students will travel to Ames the week before Thanksgiving to take place in the Opus Festival. Now that everyone is set behind me, here's the concert choir on their first piece, Jubilate. It's written in the style of the ancient Sanskrit chants, and you'll hear some of those techniques in the flirting with the upper half steps and the lower whole steps. The translation for this piece is what drew me to it in the first place and why I brought it to this group. The translation is, from untruth, lead me to truth. From darkness, lead me to light. From death, lead me to immortality. Om, peace.
Thank you.
Mrs. Michaela Prawl. Michaela is our new middle school band teacher, and we are so excited to have us with her, either way. And as a means of introduction and to simply welcome her to the family, I wanted her to join us on this piece that calls for a C instrument. She does play flute, and it is a perfect fit. So welcome, Mrs. Michaela Prawl. And our final piece for the concert fair tonight is Dreams of Me.
Thank you.
before we transition into the final piece of the evening, I really wanted to take an opportunity to thank some very important people. First of all, the administration, janitors, and secretaries. Our school building is a really busy one, especially this time of year, and their efforts in moving events and equipment around and just giving us the space to practice is so very appreciated. To the school district and Fine Arts Century Club, again, for helping us purchase basically a brand new piano is a huge thank you that is due. Over this, Eric Utmeyer, who continues to support us with his work on the sound and light booth. We appreciate him very much. And of course, to our wonderful accompanist, Lori Ferguson, for working with us and supporting us on the piano. She deserves her own round of applause. Lastly, I want to publicly thank these kids behind me and those kids over there, and many of you, actually. After only the first full week of school, I was gone for several days to be with my family as my mother passed away. My mom was one of my biggest fans, hardly ever missing any of my concerts, even when I was no longer the one singing. I was gone for almost 2 weeks, and when I returned, this choir behind me was farther along in their music than when I left. And that's pretty special. They had a more polished sound, and almost all the students in both groups had been fitted in their robes that you see behind me. Our fantastic team of student leaders and all the rest of our students made this possible, and I'm so grateful. I thanked them today at the end of class, and I wanted to do it publicly so you know what amazing kids that you raised and you support, and I want to thank them very much. Knowing and trusting that they were rehearsing while I was gone made those days a little easier, and that's worth an awful lot. So thank you, students, all of you around. Let's give them a hand, please. Okay, we've got one more song, and it requires some audience participation, but first they need to get into their spots, so have at it. I'm sure you might have wondered as you came in why all these were roped up on the sides. And this is why. We're going to surround you, and we want to sing for you and with you. We want to have a little community sing here that might be terrifying to you. It's okay. You do not have to sing well. You just have to be joyful while you're doing it. And in fact, if you just want to hum along, if you don't want to open your mouth, that's okay. Please just join us. We are going to sing the line that we will teach you several times. You can join us whenever you feel comfortable to chime in. And eventually I will have the groups start to start the round that exists around you. But you audience, just stay on that mantra. Here we go.
Two, three, this is what it sounds like.
All we need is love.
That's all there is to it.
All we need is love.
I hope you have a wonderful evening. Thanks, everyone.